What would you say, at what level are VCs, are European VCs looking at Eastern Europe enough? Because we've had some discussions with the European Investment Bank and venture capitalists overall, where we find that Eastern Europe tends to be, you know, in the bigger picture, still a bit neglected, compared to many other parts of Europe, for instance.
We did fundraising with a pre-seed from local angel investors. And we will be doing a next round of, you know, by Q2 next year, Q2 or Q3 2021. So we need to close by then, the seed round. If I tell you like the story behind Lucky Care, you will get the idea of what was happening regarding this, let's say, needing the money from, you know, family members or whatever. So you will catch that. With most of my co-founders and most of my team members, we were working at one of the very prominent local tech companies here in Armenia. And this tech company has been around for more than 10 years, actually having lots of different products in UK, Ireland, US. As a tech company, we had a financial reward, you know, financial back budget that we were giving to the employee of the month on a monthly basis. And how we were doing this, we had Slack channel as a main communication channel, you know, as a tech company. And that Slack channel, we were nominating our colleagues to become the employee of the month. So, for example, I can say, I nominate William to become the employee of the month for this or that reasons.
Yes,
Yeah. And
I vote for
then,
William.
but let's say Isaac is also nominated. And
We're
then,
competing now.
yeah. And so let's say there are like 10 nominees. And then the management would choose one of these 10 nominees to become the employee of the month, right? Let's say Isaac is being nominated. Isaac is being the employee of the month. Isaac is chosen, right? And so we were doing this for a few months. And we thought that this is going to increase what is being called employee engagement. And it's not the same as motivation. Motivation is like the tip of the iceberg. There is this term which is very, very, you know, trendy. It's becoming trendy in HR, mostly right now in the US, but it's becoming kind of trendy in other parts of the world too. So there is, you know, deeper, something, you know, much, much deeper than employee motivation, which is called employee engagement. And we wanted to raise employee engagement. In basic terms, employee engagement is that when the employee is engaged, the employee will has a very strong emotional commitment to team's goals, to company's mission, and is bringing his or her best self to the company. So the employee, when he or she goes home, is not saying, okay, I just forget about the company, what has been his or her tasks. The employee is willing to go the extra mile for the company. And so we wanted to, you know, increase this employee, what we call employee engagement. And we brought this recognition program through Employee of the Month tradition. And exactly one of the factors that increases employee engagement is the recognition. Millions of reasons, millions of things that you can do to increase engagement. One of the top ones is recognition. Second of all is the growth of the employee, personal and professional, right? So, for example, does your day look like the same as it was like 6 months ago? Have you increased your skills or whatever? Or does the company use your skills or potential, or first of all, recognizes and then use them. So we wanted to increase this employee engagement, but actually, maybe the vice versa happened. So because you had only one happy person, one employee of the month, right? Well, who was getting all of the claps, all the good stuff, the financial reward, the moral, you know, incentives, whatever. And then you have lots of other people that were and we knew they were doing something great every day, small or big achievement, but they were now being recognized. They were not being rewarded financially, right? And so you had one happy person, one engaged person, a lot of unhappy people, especially when you become nominated and not being chosen for a few months in a row. That's even worse. So we wanted to find a solution. We did a hackathon, a 24-hour hackathon inside our company, and lots of, you know, ideas generated. And one of them was Lucky Carrot. And then Lucky Carrot won because, you know, we had a jury of comprised of, you know, the management and employees, and Lucky Carrot won. And then our company became our very first paying client. And then kind of it took off from there. So Lucky Carrot started, you know, being a separate company with our team, being incorporated. And since we were a tech company, first of all, we had the developmental resources to build the platform. So you did not need that time to have to fundraise to keep your employees with you so that they can develop the platform. So this also answers your question, William.